1992, The Empire Strikes Back for the NES was a direct sequel to Star Wars, which released a year earlier. Luke's battle against the evil Empire is about to get way more personal and diverse. From blowing up Imperial probe droids on Hoth, to the elements the ice planet throws at him, everything seems more dangerous than ever before. During the game, it's possible to mount a Tauntaun and even fly a snowspeeder during the Battle of Hoth. All the characters and locales you know are represented in The Empire Strikes Back. Even Obi-Wan's Force Ghost will guide you through your journeys. Just like at the movies, The Empire Strikes Back took everything it learned from Star Wars and improved on it. It told a better story, the controls were tighter, and the visuals looked amazing. It was bigger in scope, action, and locations you could visit. As was the case with the first game, this one was also pretty hard to beat. Even the greatest Jedi players struggled to get to the ending credits. There never was a Return of the Jedi for the NES. Right after development on The Empire Strikes Back was done, the choice was made to start working on a new version of A New Hope. A super version of A New Hope.
The Force is with you, young Skywalker.